better day.
A human explanation must come from intuition. It must come from poetry. It must come ultimately from experience. And by experience, I don't mean the experimental method of science. So what we are trying to do is return the focus of attention to individual experience. We have been slaved too long to ideology transmitted hierarchically and based on a tremendously alienating instrumentality. What we need to do is empower experience. None of these well-behaved and mechanistic reductionist images of humanity take psychedelics because it's misbehaving. Misbehaving is a great sin. In fact, it's enshrined as the first sin. And somebody misbehaved, and then they got tossed out forever and their children's children into the chaos of history. It's interesting to read in Genesis why this was. It was because they will become as we are, says Yahweh. They will become as we are if they eat the fruit of the tree of knowledge. I suggest to you that this is precisely what we should seek to do. If you want a teacher, try a waterfall, or a mushroom, or a mountain wilderness, or a storm-pounded seashore. This is where the action is. It's not back in the hive. It's not in the anthill. It's not knocking your head against the floor in front of somebody who claims that because of their lineage and whose feet they wash, that you should give credence to them. Institutions seek to maximize control. That's what they're into. Did you think they were in the business of enlightening you? Saving your soul? What is real is experience. What is real is this moment. And so then what it becomes about is what are the frontiers of experience?
Thank you.
Super.